Well, the Roland Park neighborhood got into the 4th of July spirit with their annual parade. Each year, the residents there gather down Roland Avenue to enjoy decorations and floats, along with some fire trucks for the kids. And there was even a neighborhood barbecue.
Very nice, very nice. Well, you know, it wouldn't be the 4th of July without the Dundalk parade.
Yeah, it's one of the really big ones. Tens of thousands of people turned out to start their morning off with a little bit of patriotism. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey takes us there.
Historically, when the parade first started in 1935, the fire engines went 15 minutes before the parade to wake the community up.
And this year, Dundalk's 4th of July parade stepped off right on time at 8:15 Monday morning.
It's a Baltimore thing. I've grown up in Baltimore my whole life, and we've always done the parade.
I enjoy the parade. And I look forward to it every year.
And it gets bigger and better every year. This year, nearly 300 groups paraded through the streets of Dundalk, and all the favorites were there, from marching bands to community organizations throwing candy to the kids.
We come here every year, and it's just really fun, so we always come back.
This is the 77th year for the parade, and it's truly become a tradition for folks to get up early and start their 4th of July celebration with the Dundalk Parade.
It's well worth it, you know, come out and see the same people that you saw the year before that, and I've been bringing my son ever since he was a baby.
We've been coming here for how long?
Gosh,
15 plus years. Same spot, same location, this whole group.
Organizers say the tradition has lasted so long because the people in Dundalk are so spirited and so proud to sport their red, white, and blue.
It's, in this community, a very patriotic community, and it's one of the things that so many people feel so good about, that it's not hard to get people to come together and make sure that this works.
I'm proud to be an American. It's the best thing going.
And you can bet these folks are counting down till next year's celebration. Just 364 days to go. In Dundalk, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.